7654321.
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
It's the 134th episode of Morning Kicks Extra.
Woohoo! Extra means an extra dose of Randy and Jen.
And while that may not seem like the best idea, it is a great way to catch up on stuff you might have missed out on during the show.
Or if there's anything you want to listen to again.
Like your stories about the most epic way you ever got fired.
And if your eyes have been hurting after the eclipse, we're going to help you take a very special eye test.
So let's get things kicked off
on Morning Kicks Extra.
Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
So until April 19th, the Kaio Matsuri Company of Hokkaido, Japan is accepting applications for those wanting to have their liquor stored at the bottom of the sea off the shores of Hokkaido until June 2025.
The Hokkaido is surrounded by three different seas. Each one's got its own distinct conditions, but they share relatively stable temperatures and a low rate of typhoons. Notice I said low rate, not no rate. It's a low rate of typhoons, however many that is, making it apparently an ideal place for storing liquor.
So your alcohol is going to be watched 24 hours a day from a solar-powered camera so that you can watch it age underwater from your smartphone.
Oh, let's watch the liquor,
like
kids!
Watching grass grow, I would assume.
In addition, as the bottles sit there on the ocean floor, they're going to develop a calcified layer and barnacles so they become unique souvenirs all their own.
So the cost is 105,600 yen, which is about $700 per storage cage. And that holds about 12 bottles of any combination of whiskey, gin, rum, tequila, sake, wine, sparkling wine, champagne, liquors, anything like that.
Under the sea. Under the cruises. Sits all your boozes. Under the sea. Water leaks in. Mixes with gin. Tastes just like pee.
They drink before they came up with this idea anyway.
You know, this idea doesn't really hold any water.
Gin Smoothie Rehab! And this is where we assign a movie to Jen to watch over the weekend, because before she came to Kicks, she kept her eyes closed and screamed whenever she was in a theater.
So I'm being rehabilitated. So yeah. Every Friday, you assign me a movie to watch. I watch over the weekend, come back on Monday, rank it 1 to 10, and let you know what I thought about it.
So it's crazy, the movies that she has never seen. The rest of us, all these ones that are common knowledge and we all know and get the references to, she just sits there with drool on her chin.
I'm working on it. I'm getting better.
I mean, that had nothing to do with the movie. You just sit there with drool on your chin.
Thank you so much.
So this weekend, we thought we would assign her the movie Good Will Hunting, because she's been wanting to see this for a long time.
I'm aware of it, but I don't really know what it's about.
Like 40 years she's been wanting to watch this. So it's a 1989 drama. That's when it came out. Written by and starring Matt Damon as Will Hunting, who has genius-level IQ but chooses to work as a janitor at MIT. So when he solves a difficult graduate-level math problem, his talents are discovered by Professor Gerard Lambeau, played by Stellan Skarsgård, who decides to help the misguided youth reach his potential. So when he's arrested for attacking a police officer, Professor Lambeau makes a deal to get leniency for him if he will get treatment from therapist Sean McGuire, played by Robin Williams.
Oh, okay.
And most of the movie is about the sessions between the Robin Williams character and the Matt Damon character.
Is he proving that Will Hunting is good? It's good, Will Hunting.
Yes. Matt Damon, by the way, this is kind of interesting. He started writing that film as a final assignment for a playwriting class he was taking at Harvard University, where he's a graduate from.
Oh, no way. That's cool.
And instead of writing a one-act play like he had been assigned, he ended up submitting a 40-page script for the class, which turned out to be Good Will Hunting. He said the only scene, though, from the script that survived, he says, and it survived verbatim, was the one where Will Hunting meets his therapist, Sean McGuire, for the first time. Very famous scene.
Okay, cool.
So he asked Ben Affleck, of course, to help him, because apparently those two are unable to exist without each other. And they developed the screenplay together, and they completed it. And at first, it was written as a thriller about a young man in the rough and tumble streets of South Boston who possesses a superior intelligence and is targeted by the government with a heavy-handed recruitment.
Sounds like Ben Affleck.
Yeah, but somehow that did not become a thing.
So where do I watch it?
You can watch it in most of your streaming platforms, but unfortunately, the only place you can watch it for free is Max. So if you have a subscription to that, otherwise you're going to pay $4 to watch it. It's rated R. You probably shouldn't let the kids watch it. A lot of language, some violence. They will go to sleep within the first 10 minutes of it. I swear, your kids will be bored to tears by this movie.
I'm excited for for this one. So I'm going to watch Good Will Hunting over the weekend, and then I'll come back on Monday, rank it 1 to 10, let you know what I thought about it.
With Jen's Movie Rehab.
Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
Yesterday, with the whole eclipse, I was a little disappointed.
I know. You haven't been real positive about it. I thought it was cool. I liked it.
I sacrificed my phone's camera and took like 5 or 6 pictures, and every single one of them looked the same. I started taking pictures at around 1:45 and took them all the way to 2, and it's... Oh, there's the sun.
What's really funny is yesterday we were like, be careful with your phone cameras. Yeah. You might mess up the lens. And today you're like, my lens and my camera's not working real great.
Well, everything looks kind of hazy now, so I think it actually damaged the lens of my phone. So you're welcome.
Better your camera than your eyes. Were you looking at it with your naked eye?
Not a lot. So, I mean, a little bit.
Randy!
When it hurt, I quit.
You're not supposed to look at it at all with the naked eye, unless it's at totality, which we never hit here.
You're not. But you know what,
man?
For people who think they may have damaged or done some damage to their cornea or their retina in their eye from looking at the eclipse, it's probably a good idea to get an eye test to see that. So we actually have a radio eye test that you can perform yourself to see if you damaged your eye. Here it is. Listen.
This is the radio eye test.
All right, everyone listening to the radio right now, please tell me, how many fingers am I holding up? No. How about now? No. Okay, how about you tell me what the letters say on this wall next to me?
L.
No. All right, you're totally blind. You shouldn't be driving.
Wait. That was the radio eye test. Tune in tomorrow for the radio prostate exam.
Now, bend over and crack a smile.
No!
Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
A lot of folks are like, well...
It's over now.
So what do I do with all my glasses and these boxes I made?
Well, if you didn't get glasses yesterday, or if you missed out on viewing the eclipse, we should look forward into the future.
Oh my gosh, you could buy them on sale today, right?
That's right. Everywhere there's going to be a huge blowout on eclipse glasses, so you can be ready for the year 2044.
The eclipse was yesterday, so there's never been a better time to save big at the post-eclipse eclipse glasses blowout sale. With current rates of inflation, eclipse glasses could cost more than double by the next eclipse in 20 years.
Now I'll be prepared for 2045, and I saved future me $15.
If you felt like an idiot being in public with your pinhole cereal box, then don't let this once-in-a-generation sale pass you by.
I had to work yesterday and missed the whole thing, but I'm investing in Eclipse glasses now because I'll be a retired senior citizen by the next one.
Don't burn future money while not burning out your retinas 2 decades from now. Come to the post-eclipse Eclipse glasses blowout sale, and in 20 years, you'll thank yourself.
Morning Kicks Extra.
Taxes are actually due next week, by the way.
We've been talking about it a lot here lately, but it's because the tax deadline is this Monday, and a lot of people tend to put this off till the very last minute. I get it, but if you've got a refund coming, wouldn't you want that as soon as possible?
I would think so. So go file your taxes and get you the refund.
Yeah, because everybody is waiting on a refund.
Doing my taxes.
Morning Kicks Extra.
We're talking about your fire stories, either the time that you got fired or you should have been fired.
What's the most epic way that you ever got fired?
I was in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Pulled into a gas station. It was a time where they had to turn switch the pumps on.
Right.
Went switch pump on. And I walked in the store and I looked around. There wasn't anybody in there. And of course, my first thought was they've been robbed and the guy's dead in the walking cooler.
Right.
And I looked around. There was nobody there. So I called the police because I left my fingerprints. And police came and apparently the guy just was mad and walked off and left the store completely open. And that was it.
Wow. Just left the convenience store sitting there empty.
Yeah.
I mean, what an opportunity that was missed. You could have gotten away with some lottery tickets, maybe a Snickers or two, but instead you had to be the good guy and call the police.
I know, but my fingerprints were all over the place.
You got a good point. I guess. What about you? What's the time you either should have been fired or got fired for something?
I was working at Tyson's. I was a live hanger.
What's a live hanger?
A live hanger is a person who pulls the live chickens off the belt, hangs them on the hooks, and sends them to the kill room.
Oh, boy, right on.
My boss was saying, hey, you need to hurry up. I'm like, well, can you back up so I can hurry up? He's like, no. I turn around, squeeze his chicken right in his face.
What happens when you squeeze a chicken?
Well, needless to say, it cannot hold its bowel movement.
Chicken poop everywhere?
He laughed. He's like, okay, I get it. I understand. I'm leaving you alone.
You don't have to squirt me twice with chicken poop to get the message.
Have you ever been fired, or do you have an epic got fired story?
Well, I was working at a bacon plant.
Wait a minute.
There's a plant that produces bacon?
But how do you grow that?
I did great at every job in the place, and there was one left.
She's not going to tell us, Jim.
And it was holding the side of a pig up to a saw to cut it. And I said, I'm not doing this. I can't. And they go, you have to. I tried twice, and it just flew everywhere. So the bell went off for break, and it said, here's your paychecks. And I grabbed mine, and I kept on walking.
Out of here. No more cutting up pig for you.
I don't think so.
That's not how you make bacon.
Yeah, she just said at the beginning of the call, you grow up from a plant.
That's right.
And I want to know what that plant is.
The bacon plant.
How do you fertilize a bacon plant?
You don't want to know, Randy.
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
We're talking about your most epic got fired story, the time you got fired in epic fashion or should have been fired for something you did.
I was actually fired from my job, but they just didn't fire me the day they were planning on doing it because it was my birthday. And I walked in with a birthday cake that my wife had made me. They were planning on firing me that day. They realized it was my birthday, so they waited till Friday.
What you should have done is come in with a birthday cake every day. You know,
oh,
I mean,
you couldn't
that's
have done that. Nobody would have believed that if you did that. You can't get away with that. That would be ridiculous.
Then they can't fire you if you keep bringing them cake.
Or if you keep having birthdays.
What is your epic got fired story?
Well, we had a Christmas party a few years back.
Oh, boy.
And there was about 50 people there, women and men included. And they give me a Christmas present of a pink teddy.
A pink teddy, let me guess.
Somebody said put it on.
I knew it.
I stripped down naked and I put this pink teddy on.
Oh my gosh. Let me guess. Was there a little alcohol involved here?
A tad, a bit.
Yeah, let me guess. You modeled a teddy and your boss thought it was hilarious.
Until Monday morning.
There were pictures taken, huh?
I think so.
You know what? We would be very interested in seeing those if you still got them.
I don't think I'm going to go with them.
Gonna just leave those in that file over there marked human resource.
I mean, if you wanted to message them to us, though, our inbox is open.
No, I don't want to see that. I'm trying to eat breakfast.
What is your epic got fired story?
Well, I was working for a delivery company, and I had to deliver to a nursing home.
Uh-huh.
And when I pulled up, I should have parked outside, but I tried to pull up underneath the awning, and I got the box truck stuck up underneath the awning.
Oh my God.
And it cost over $10,000 to fix it, but I kept my job. I don't understand how. But goodness, I did.
Should have been fired.
Do you have a should have been fired or got fired story?
I know someone that tried to take off with something pretty expensive.
What was it?
He was trying to take a customer's car.
Say what?
He got into an argument with the boss, and the boss fired him there on the spot. He walked back out into the shop, got in the car, and tried to drive off with it.
What?
Luckily, it was an enterprise car with OnStar, and they cut the engine through OnStar.
So, well, lucky for that, I guess. Might want to examine that whole interview process before hiring.
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
So we're talking about your epic got fired stories.
Either you got fired or you should have been fired for something.
I actually was informed that I was losing my job on Halloween while I was dressed as a nun.
Try dealing with that guilt.
Yeah, good job confessing to that.
Did you get fired for something or should have been fired?
All right, so I worked in a corporate setting, a three-piece suit every day.
Right.
And made the mistake of allowing the boss's wife to go ahead and seduce me on a drunken, you know, adventure.
No.
After work one night. And he found out about it and confronted me in the office. And he's like, hey, listen, yeah, she's a Mary Magdalene. It happens. But you're a good hard worker. I'll see you tomorrow. Have a day of R&R.
So blamed it on his wife.
Well, you know, it does take two to tango.
It does. And I was intoxicated, and so was she. It happens.
Unfortunately.
But, yeah, definitely should have been fired for that one. But
oh, my
was
God.
Not.
What is your fired story, or should have been fired story?
So, I worked at a hotel. I used to let people stay for free.
Well, right on. You know, if you ever decide to work at a hotel again, you and I need to talk.
That's right.
You just call Randy and Jen, because we would love to stay for free.
Yes, we would.
Awesome. I'll give you guys a call if that happens again.
That's a better deal than even Priceline.com or any of those.
Yeah.
Yes. I can get better deals than they can.
You stay for free.
Is there a time that you should have been fired or did get fired?
I fell asleep on the toilet and my supervisor found me.
Wait.
I didn't get fired. I was going pee and I fell asleep on the toilet and a supervisor caught me because I was snoring.
I once fell asleep right in the middle of a weather forecast. The guy had to lean over and bump me to get me to wake up and continue giving the forecast, and I didn't know where I was.
Nice.
Probably should have fired. How to tell when you're working too hard.
Is there a time that you should have been fired or you did get fired?
Ways people quit, right?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't do it, but I worked for a tractor trailer over the road company, and I got called to recover a semi that a driver had left.
Had just left somewhere?
Had just left it, but the kicker is he left it in a pond. And it gets worse. The tow truck pulled the truck out of the pond, and we were loaded onto the trailer, and the tow truck driver said, you might want to get somebody to come in and clean this out.
Oh, no.
I looked in, and the sleeper berth of the semi was completely full of Walmart sacks that he had defecated and left in there.
He pooped in the Walmart bag and put him in the sleeper.
Yep.
They gotta go somewhere.
Oh, no, that's nasty.
They gotta go somewhere.
No, not like that, though.
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
Hey, join us on the next edition of Morning Kicks Extra.
We're gonna be talking about the worst way that your kids have ever embarrassed you in public.
Here's looking at you, temper tantrum, 3 years old at the mall.
In the meantime, don't forget to check out our blog at kicks1025.com.
You can check out all of the latest Morning Kicks karaoke songs.
And you can watch us live on most social platforms every weekday morning starting at 7.
Make sure to like, follow, and smash that subscribe button.
Bonk. Don't miss Morning Kicks with Randy and Jen. Weekday mornings from 6 to 10 on the 4 states' number one for country, Kicks 102.5.